gonna do a quick, well, maybe not a quick experience report, but an experience report nonetheless on a drug combination for the first time ever. Not a specific drug combination, because if I were to do specific drug combinations, I'd be making about 200 or 300 more videos, and I would just be making videos for the sake of making videos rather than, you know, any useful purpose. Anyway, I'm going to get right into it, and the drug combinations I'm talking about are stimulant-stimulant combinations. I'm going to do an experience report on that. Now, I've had a lot of stimulant-stimulant combinations, many without even realizing it until much later, but I think the most common stimulant combinations I've had are legal stimulants with other legal stimulants and soft legal stimulants. So for example, ginseng with guarana, or ginseng with caffeine, or ginseng with guarana and caffeine. Now, this sounds pretty non-intimidating and pretty like, oh, they're some light drugs. Anyone who hasn't taken a large amount of these drugs with each other has no idea what that's like. So, to give an example, if you right now decide to buy an entire 100 grams of caffeine and decide to eat an entire gram of caffeine, you will be pretty fucking insane for a small amount of time. Caffeine is not a very strong drug in coffee, or when you have a few of those little caffeine pills, you know, gives you a little buzz. But when you're having a gram or 2 grams of caffeine at a time, you understand that caffeine is definitely a drug, that it's not just you know, a little fun thing that's in coffee that doesn't really alter you at all. You know, if you have one coffee or two coffees, or maybe even three coffees if you drink a lot of coffees in a day. If you have three coffees at once, most people feel a little bit weird. But if you have a whole gram of caffeine, which is roughly 10 coffees, maybe 11 depending on how you make them, you'll feel the effects, right? And you know, you feel a bit buzzed, a bit stimulated. It's kind of like an adrenaline rush, but there's none of that kind of dopamine niceness. So I find caffeine to be quite an edgy chemical when you have a lot of it. So I've taken it before with ginseng and guarana at the same time. Ginseng basically just to calm it down, and guarana just because it's another stimulant. And I find when you mix for example caffeine, a lot of caffeine with a little bit of ginseng, it takes the edge off. When you combine quite a lot of caffeine with a hell of a lot of ginseng, it adds a different edge. So it's like in between being extremely calm and extremely focused for a couple of minutes to being just completely gone, as if you were kind of getting the energy you get from cocaine without any of the mental stimulation or any of the kind of "I'm the best in the world" stimulation. Only anxiety, but no kind of interior want to die, no kind of interior depression or psychotic destruction that you get from cocaine. Not quite on the level of that. When you mix it with guarana and ginseng, it's such a high level. That is some pretty heavy stimulation. But the problem with these kind of things in combination is there's just no focus to them, and you don't really get much of the good feeling from most of these over-the-counter things. Like if I have a lot of caffeine, for example, I do get a good feeling and a, you know, stimulated feeling from the adrenaline rush, but I don't get a sense of well-being, a sense of being strong or happy. I actually feel very anxious, and when these are in combination, I feel extremely anxious, have an extreme amount of energy, and it's just not a good time. It's probably very dangerous for the heart as well. You know, by no means are they necessarily safe because they're legal. Caffeine is far safer than, for example, cocaine, amphetamine, methamphetamine, and most of the illegal counterparts. The same with guarana and ginseng. In combination, you have to have a hell of a lot to go to the hospital. But I can see how it's possible. I've had heart palpitations from just caffeine alone when I've had 2 or 3 grams at a time. And I've definitely had heart palpitations from the combinations, and not even, you know, the speed of the heart, just the level of anxiety can be reduced with that much energy. I can very well imagine people doing stupid things, not like on cocaine where you'd hit someone just because you didn't care, but more like someone would have a problem with you and you'd have so much energy you'd fight back, and you freak out and you jump into the sea and just do ridiculous stuff because you have too much energy to think logically, you know? And yeah, I find these combinations quite counteractive. I don't like them. Now, I actually find that stimulants that act on the dopamine, for example, amphetamines, amphetamines, cocaine, and you know, methylphenidate, modafinil, these kind of things. I find with maybe 100 or 200 milligrams, like a low dose of caffeine for me, yeah, it really improves these stimulants for me. It's obviously very dangerous to mix stimulants with stimulants, so by no means am I advocating you should. But yeah, my experience with high or just medium doses, it seems like a medium dose of a dopaminergic with a low dose or a relatively low dose of caffeine, you know, it seems to give slightly better results because you get that slight amount of adrenaline from that small bit of caffeine, but you don't get enough of the anxiety from the caffeine to really hurt you so much because the dopamine that's going through you from the dopaminergics kind of counteracts that, so you don't really get as much of the anxiety. So it's kind of like getting a lot of the energy positive from caffeine and a lot of the creative positive from caffeine whilst having none of its negatives. And at the same time, it's kind of like the negatives of both cancel each other out, but you get the positives of both. I find when you have a high dose of a dopaminergic with a low dose of caffeine, it kind of improves the feeling. You still get some of that anxiety, but it's not useful for focus as such. It's not optimum for focus. I find that dopaminergics in combination with ginseng are perfect. Small doses of ginseng, even medium doses of ginseng. Large doses of ginseng are fun, but they're not useful. So for example, a small dose of ginseng with a medium dose of a functional dopaminergic stimulant such as methylphenidate, I find is just, yeah, one of the best things for focus ever. Not so bad for energy. And yeah, not really any negative, slightly more positive feeling than the dopaminergics on their own, I find. Higher levels of ginseng, again, no anxiety as such. Even high levels of ginseng with high levels of dopaminergics sometimes get high level anxiety or a bit of anxiety from that combination, just from the dopaminergic. I generally find from a high level of dopaminergic you get a little bit of anxiety, but it's not the same kind of manic anxiety you get from caffeine. It's more of a sort of too intense, too many thoughts kind of anxiety, too fast kind of anxiety. You're anxious because you just don't understand why you're going so fast, but not really for any other reason, I find. And yeah, with guarana, I don't find guarana does that much on its own. It seems to be more of a subtle stimulant. It seems to be more of a mental affecting stimulant. I like guarana for that because it's kind of a background stimulant, and I find you can add it to any stimulant combination. But I don't know if it's actually worth it. It feels like it's worth adding a low dose of guarana with a medium or low dose of dopaminergic because it just makes you slightly more mentally acute without really affecting you in every way. But apart from that, yeah, I don't find it very useful in general. Guarana is something I'd have every day, I guess, on its own just to kind of improve mental cognition in general, but it's not really anything, you know, strong or remarkable as such. And then the last one I'll move on to is dopaminergics with other dopaminergics. This can be a very dangerous game. Not as I've discovered myself or discovered from other people, just as I've observed from my own experiences. For example, when taking, I've done this a few times, I've taken modafinil with methylphenidate. I am extremely focused when I take modafinil with methylphenidate. When I have a medium dose of both, it's like having a high dose of either, but kind of, it's just the right combination. It seems to be hitting the right parts of dopamine at the same time. That, yeah, it's just perfect focus. But sometimes I feel kind of sad. I'm not sure why, I just feel a little bit sad. It's weird because it doesn't stop me from functioning at all. I'm functioning at a higher level, but I just feel, you know, slightly depressed. I don't dwell on it like when I'd normally be depressed or upset. I just feel upset. It's hard for me to explain or really understand myself as such. But this is the kind of thing I get from, say, methylphenidate with modafinil. I find mixing methylphenidates with different phenidates is just a bad idea. You either get too much focus or too much stimulation, and things just become really, really strange when you mix phenidates with other phenidates, I find. I find that mixing modafinil with certain things, depending on what it is, can kind of amplify the effects and at the same time take off a lot of edge. For example, when I have modafinil with cocaine, which from the heartbeat rate that I was feeling for myself, I would say it's very dangerous. I think it's very dangerous to mix dopaminergics with other dopaminergics. Even the modafinil and the methylphenidate, because I have no idea what it's doing to my heart. My heart rate is slightly faster than it would be on either of them on their own, and I think it has. They both have different interactions with the heart, so you know it could probably lead to irregular rhythms. So you have an increased heartbeat rate, I'd say, probably, but you probably have irregular rhythms at the same time. Not a very good combination at all. So this is why I'm saying I don't think it's safe to mix dopaminergics with dopaminergics in any way at all. I would say mixing amphetamines isn't generally necessary. I wouldn't mix it with modafinil, for example. To be honest, yeah, I just wouldn't mix it. It's not something I mixed. I've mixed it with modafinil before, and I found it just too understimulating. Like, it felt like the stimulation effects cancelled out, and I just got kind of this pure focus, but a disinterest in reality, a disconnect from reality. I always kind of get that, and I kind of got that when I mixed amphetamine with cocaine, that the opposite, just too much physical stimulation, massive disconnect from reality, at the same time a massive connect to very primal urges of reality, such as like, I don't know, just kind of sex, aggression levels. You know, it would be a great thing to rave or go into a war with, but you know, if you're going to rave, it'd have to be pretty extreme one, and you'd have to have someone making sure you're not going to rip someone apart. Amphetamine and cocaine just isn't the combination, and same, amphetamine with methylphenidates, yeah, seems to lead me to aggressive parts of the brain for some reason. I find amphetamine combinations with other stimulants, like other dopaminergics, is a bad idea. I find it's quite useful to mix amphetamine, strangely enough, with caffeine. I'm not sure why that is. And yeah, as far as methylphenidates go as well, they're a weird one to combine. Like I said, not combining them with each other, it's just a bad idea. Cocaine, actually, it's weird. It's all of these things are dangerous, by the way, just to let you know, for sure. Don't try these things. It's not good for your health. I mean, I can't stop you doing what you do, but it's definitely not healthy for you at all. But yeah, I find cocaine mixes well with a lot of drugs that aren't stimulants, but not really with the other stimulants as such. Yeah, I mean, it's the kind of thing when you mix it with other stimulants, it just makes you more of an animal, but not necessarily like you're gonna hurt someone, just like you've got much more potential to. Whereas amphetamine mixed with other dopaminergics, just, yeah, it seems to make me aggressive at least. So yeah, my recommendation for me, I guess, is to only really take dopaminergics with non-dopaminergics, to just not go too crazy with the non-dopaminergic stimulants that I'm using together, really. Unless, I mean, the only thing I would really do now as a dopaminergic combination is some dopaminergics with other non-dopaminergics that aren't stimulants, or maybe phenidates with modafinil is doable, but it just seems dangerous every time I take it. Just, there's always something that doesn't feel quite right about it. Anyway, that was my experience reports on drug combinations, specifically on stimulant drug combinations. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you another day.